Hello and welcome to episode 10 of Let's Play Civilization 6 Japan. We are picking up where we last left off. We're in the middle of consolidating our empire. I'm having some happiness issues, you can see here, so I'm trying to see what I can do to resolve that, and that's kind of delayed our settlement. So I was trying to figure out if I want to settle another city down here to just to protect our southern flank, but haven't decided that yet. One of the nice things with a Civ 6 is these support units that I can stack with my my main units, and these are actually quite good medics. It helps the units around them heal as well, so.
Market economy, however, the individual has some possibility of escaping from the power of the state.
Thank you.
Bolt actions speak louder than words.
I don't like the fact that I have to give up this plot of land for the Eiffel Tower, which I wouldn't mind building, but it's a bit of a trade-off. I want to see if I can get another great person. Well, let's try to grab the great merchant again. What can I do here? Let's do a... We'll send him to Rome. No, actually, maybe not. Send him to Toledo. Yeah, he can steal that post there. I just need to level them up. It would be nice if I can level them up. No luck with our spies.
Thank you.
freight merchant, Eureka for flight, okay. Okay, so we did get our spy out, at least, on that one. Another barbarian camp here.
Remember that politics, colonialism, imperialism, and war also originated in the human brain.
Set of artillery outside. Tusha Preslov.
Entek nenshahu erheper embach pai en. Pai ek meshahezi.
The thing with the AI is I think it measures your power based mostly on how many units you have, not the quality of the units. So it tends to think that smaller, more advanced armies are less powerful. I think they should fix that, but it's not up to me, obviously. But that would be how I feel about it. harbor shipping. Took a bad deal there, but the extra happiness is, or amenity is nice to have for now. But that was a 3-for-1 trade. I'm saving money right now because as soon as I get archaeology done, or natural history done, I can get archaeologists. I might rush by a few of them, and I'll see how many I want to rush by. Still slightly behind on all the great leaders.
Benjamin Franklin may have discovered electricity, but it was the man who invented the meter who made the money.
Okay. That, I'm gonna get a power plant going here.
works on natural history, we constantly find details of the marvelous.
Okay, we'll take that. Ooh, expensive. Okay, let's rush by a archaeologist here. A few relics that we can grab close by. There's one there. There aren't actually very many artifacts. Oh, there's one here, okay. But yeah, there's not too many nearby here that I can grab. There's one up here, okay. There's one there. Building power plants in all my core cities because they'll be self-reinforcing eventually and they'll get everyone something. I'm gonna build an archaeologist here as well, or buy one.
improvement makes straight roads.
Grab those sites here, and this one I'm going to send down here to grab this one here on this island, and this one here. Mistake, guys. Gives me a reason to go to war. One thing I like about the archaeologists in this game is they are much more mobile than in Civ 5. So it actually feels like you get a lot done. You're not constantly waiting for them to get to where they need to be. Yeah, we're way behind on this. I wish I could get Carl Sagan.
Chemistry is the dirty part of physics.
Like right here, I could move and grab the artifact on the same turn. Okay. And again, move and grab artifact on the same turn. We'll sleep him here. I'm gonna send this to check out this zone here to make sure that we can grab the artifacts here safely. There's a barb camp up here. Maybe I should send the pikes up. Oh, I can upgrade them, okay. We'll take it. Refuse deal. We're not going to give them something for nothing. The Greeks again are trying to settle here. So the Scythians and the Romans are at war.
The cars haven't advanced that much since we were kids. When you boil it down, it's still a gas combustion engine.
Oh, I see what they're going for. They're going for the oil. Can't buy any more tiles here. I should get a Eureka bonus once one of these power plants finishes, and they're both going to finish the same turn. And the other thing here is, how far back am I on tech? Oh, I'm falling back 48. Yeah, falling back quite a bit. I need to pick up my pace. Yeah, we lost Carl Sagan, which sucks. We are getting the okay, I guess one of the AIs passed on it, so
a great merchant has come to our civilization.
That's why I got it. Thank you. Yeah, that's a pretty weak sauce. Pretty weak sauce, great person, if I may say so. Call me whatever you want.
Your Excellency, I feel it is time to build neighborhoods with-
It's the Industrial Revolution and the group. Battleship. Aim for the moon.
Well, it's going to be hard to do Eureka for flight. But I think this is a good place to end our video. It's a bit of a boring episode. There's really not much to say, actually, just except for building and spamming stuff. Let me pick up that last relic there. I guess we'll do computers. Thank you. on him. Yeah, I'll decide what I want next turn. So thank you very much for watching, and have a nice day.